Hello, I am Parag Nandu and I am second year MD student. Today I would like to examine your thorax and lung. Is it fine with you? Okay, so before starting with the procedure, I would request that please can you remove the shirt? So let's proceed with the examination.
Begin the examination with a brief survey of the patient's thorax and respiration. Note the shape of the chest and how it moves. Is the thorax symmetrical? Are there any bony deformities? Observe the rate, rhythm, depth, and effort of breathing. And listen for any audible sounds of breathing that may indicate respiratory distress. Now, listen and count number of breaths per minute. Normally, a resting adult breathes easily, quietly, and regularly about 14 to 20 times a minute. Inspect the patient's neck for retraction of the accessory muscles, namely supraclavicular, sternocleidomastoid, scalene muscles, suggesting respiratory difficulty. Normally, this is not present. Palpate in the sternal notch to check the position of the trachea. It should be in the midline. Check the patient's color for circumoral and nail bed cyanosis, a bluish color arising from deoxygenation. Normally, lips and fingernails are pink in color.
Now I'll start the examination for posterior chest.
Now, examine the posterior thorax beginning with inspection. Observe the chest for contours, symmetry, and deformity. Also inspect the overlying skin, then palpate the chest wall for any areas of pain or tenderness. To test chest expansion, place your thumbs close to the patient's spine at the level of the 10th ribs and spread your fingers lightly across the lateral thorax. Ask the patient to inhale and exhale deeply and fully while watching the divergence of the thumbs, normally about 2 cm, and feel for the range and symmetry of the movement.
When I touch behind and palpate, you have to just continue saying 99, 99, 99. Okay.
Next, we palpate symmetrically for tactile firmitis. Feel for the vibrations of tactile firmitis as the patient repeats 99, 99, 99, or similar phrases consisting of two or three same syllables. Using the ball of the hand or ulnar surface, identify the areas of increased, decreased, or absent firmitis. Palpate and compare the symmetric area of lung as you identify the areas of increased, decreased, or absent firmitis. Continue the examination by percussing the chest in a systematic manner. We begin by hyperextending the middle finger of our left hand, also known as the plexometer finger, pressing its distal interphalangeal joint firmly on the lung surface to be percussed. We must avoid the contact of any other part of the hand as that might dampen out the vibrations. Then, strike using tip of the right hand third flexor finger to set vibration. Using this method, percuss down the chest wall from the apices to the base of the lung in a ladder pattern. Listen to the intensity, pitch, and duration of your percussion notes. Next, ask the patient to breathe out and use percussion to identify the lower level of the diaphragm. Ask the patient to take a full inspiration and measure diaphragmatic exertion. It is usually 3 to 5 cm. Next, we go for auscultation using the diaphragm beginning from the apices to the bases of the lung in a ladder pattern, comparing breath sounds in symmetrical areas. Listen to the intensity, pitch, and duration of inspiratory and expiratory breath sounds. Decide what type of breath sounds are audible. Normal vesicular breath sounds are soft and low pitched and are normally heard during inspiration and first third of expiration. Bronchial breath sounds are harsher, louder, and higher in pitch than the vesicular breath sounds. They are often heard over the trachea and main stem bronchi. Expiratory sounds last longer than the inspiratory sound. A silent gap may separate these two sounds in the bronchial breath sounds. Bronchovesicular sounds can be heard in the first and second interspaces anteriorly and between the scapulae posteriorly. They have intermediate pitch and intensity. Inspiratory and expiratory sounds are equal in duration and may be separated by silent interval. We must check for added breath sounds that are superimposed on usual breath sounds. They may include crackles, wheezes, and ronchi, indicating underlying consolidation.
Just say 99.
If we hear abnormally located bronchovesicular or bronchial breath sounds, assess transmitted voice sounds. While auscultating the chest against the patient, ask the patient to say 99. Normally, the sounds transferred through the chest walls are muffled and indistinct. Louder sounds reflecting transmission through airless tissues are called bronchophony.
99.
Just say E.
Next, test for egophony of E to A changes which occur in lobar consolidation for pneumonia. Ask the patient to say
E.
Normally, we hear a muffled long E sound. If the underlying tissue is consolidated, the E sound changes to A in quality.
Just whisper 1, 2, 3.
Finally, check for whispered pectoriloquy. Ask the patient to whisper 1, 2, 3. The whispered voice is usually heard faintly or indistinctly, if at all. Clear or louder sounds suggest underlying consolidation. To examine the anterior thorax, have the patient lie supine and breathe normally. Observe the chest for contours, symmetry, and deformity. Also, inspect the overlying skin. Then assess chest expansion. Place your thumb along each costal margin with hands along the lateral ribcage. Ask the patient to take a deep breath.
Just breathing deeply.
Observe how far thumbs diverge as the thorax expands and feel for the extent and symmetry of respiratory movement. Next, we palpate systematically for tactile firmitis using ball or ulnar surface of hand. When examining a woman, displace the breast gently. Next, percuss the anterior chest and the lateral chest. The heart usually produces an area of dullness to the left of the sternum from the third to fifth interspaces. To ausculcate the chest anteriorly and laterally, ask the patient to breathe with his mouth open and somewhat more deeply than normally. Compare the symmetric areas of the lung using the ladder pattern. Listen to the breath sounds for intensity and identify any variation or adventitious sound.
Just say 99. Okay.